From America's most honored regional news network, this is New England Weekend.
Former priest James Porter. Porter was an admitted pedophile. He was accused of molesting dozens of children. And he died yesterday of cancer. NEC's John Maroney has more.
Christine Hickey is relieved, knowing James Porter, the former priest who raped her nearly 40 years ago, is no longer around.
Every single time I've seen his face, I get sort of this terror reaction. It's hard every single time. So just from my own life, I'll be glad after this dies down not to hopefully ever have to see him again.
The 70-year-old Porter died Friday, nearly 12 years after he admitted to sexually assaulting as many as 100 children during the 60s and 70s in the Fall River Diocese.
And I think that the most important thing is that they don't have to worry about that anymore.
Phil Salviano is with Survivors Network of Those Abused by Priests. He says Father Porter's case was one of the first to show how the church moved priests accused of molesting children from parish to parish. Plus, he says it was the first to test the theory of recovered memory.
It was the first instance of repressed memory coming into play, because Frank Fitzpatrick, the victim who tracked him down and was, you know, really heroic in his efforts to bring Porter to justice, had forgotten about his experiences for much of his adult life.
The repressed memory of another victim of clergy abuse helped convict Paul Shanley of raping a young boy. The defrocked priest will be sentenced next week. Another notorious figure in the clergy sex scandal, John Gagan, was murdered in his prison cell last year.
It seems like the most important guys are now off the streets for good.
Christine Hickey says she was raped by James Porter while he was working as a priest in Stoneham, Massachusetts. She was 10 at the time, and it has affected her life. But she says she's never been one to give up.
It'll always be with me, but I think it has less and less effect on me as more time passes.
James Porter finished his sentence last year but was still being held while authorities tried to decide if he was still a sexually dangerous person. In the newsroom, John Maroney, NECN.